In today's episode of 2 Minute Tuesday, Cimquest visits our customer, the University of Maryland, to see how they're taking a leading role in metal additive manufacturing.
Good afternoon. My name is Rick Blanton. I'm the Director of Technical Operations for the Clark School of Engineering. And I'm here today to introduce you to the Advanced Fabrication Lab and Terrapin Works. This lab is unique on campus because it's one of the few spaces where you're able to go from ideation all the way to a fully functioning electromechanical product in a single space. This is the desktop metal shop ecosystem. This is a binding jet process. Because we're working with students who are primarily running this equipment, our job is to make sure that they go home safe and are able to go out into industry knowing what they need to know.
My name is John Wolf. I'm the technical coordinator for the desktop metal shop system here at Terrapin Works. And basically what I do is I'm the first point of contact for customers whenever they want to run the machine. And I also serve to train new trainees on the machine and anyone who wants to work with it more. I would say, considering what it does, it's super easy. You know, the documentation is really good. Everything is very well laid out. The software kind of makes it hard for you to mess up. And the machines are good at what they do. I think absolutely there's a future for metal additive. I mean, I got into it. I'm an aerospace engineering major, so I got into it because I knew about relativity space, who's doing the same sort of thing, you know, groundbreaking in that industry. So I think absolutely, you know, whenever you're running the machine and you're here and, you know, you're in there in the 3M respirators, and just, you know, it's a really good way to foster teamwork. And also the experience that you get obviously is fun, but just running the machines, we have a fun time. So it's a nice place to work.
Between the capabilities of working with plastics and metals, you're able to produce items such as this.
I'm Winston. I am one of the lab coordinators here at the University of Maryland Terrapin Works. And this is my 30-pound BattleBot Warlock. The biggest, I guess, use of the desktop metal has been the fact that I don't have to sit there monitoring a CNC lathe for like 8 hours as it outputs a lot of the parts. I submitted these parts and I waited about a week. I went along with my day-to-day life. They got printed, they got sintered. Desktop metal provides a very nice array of machining characteristics for different shapes. It allows weird geometries, it allows strange mounting positions, but you can do that while still maintaining the necessary engineering rigidity and tolerances to hold it onto the ship itself.
If you want to learn how to leverage metal additive in your shop or schools, please contact Cimquest today.